Hello everyone and welcome back. I am Avarian with Improving Daily and we are playing Ultimate General American Civil War. And just to let you all know, this is 3 o'clock at night here and I am beyond tired. But I gotta get this out for you because I really want to see this finished off. Now, we left off last time by reinforcing all our regiments, which means two regiments pretty much, or divisions, I don't know, first division, brigade, yeah, first two brigades, and Walton, who is still really, really well equipped with the veterans, can he go up to 2,000? Yes, he can now. We'll be doing that later on after this battle. Hopefully we'll gain a lot of cash and a lot of recruits, and we'll be able to not only reinforce all our regiments but actually increase them to 2,000 soldiers a pop. Walton will be reinforced with veterans, and Loomis will also be reinforced with veterans, hopefully, and we will be able to buy those two extra equipment while adding more troops to this. That's just a hope. We are really short on manpower, and I really need to get some hold of how to increase that manpower. As far as I know, it is through politics, which increases the amount of golden recruits I get. Yeah, so that's what we need to do. Right now we've got a huge army. We got 9,000 troops plus extra a couple hundred troops on these Scales and Woods divisions. Now, I hope this will go well. I don't have any increased equipment. Let's have a look at what I have. I've got some farmer equipment in my stock. I can actually sell that because I don't really need that. I got not really got any skirmisher models. Last time I did this battle, my skirmisher units got over 2,000 kills, and I really want to add a skirmisher division to this. But creating a new division and then adding that as a brigade is not really an option right now. So, let's just increase the amount of supplies. Can I actually? No, let me think. Ah, this is really difficult. I can get Palmetto, which is a fire rate of 40, effect rate of 250, accuracy 13.5, melee 91. So it's a better accuracy rifle, slightly. It's got the same fire rate and the same damage, the same effective range, and the same melee, a little better melee. So it is an upgrade. And I could get 2,000 of those and actually increase the... and actually hand those over to Walton, which will make Walton more efficient, for four reputation. I could do that, but I'm not really sure I want to do that, because my idea is to get Walton back up and then throw him some Harper's Ferries, which are so insanely accurate. Lawrence is actually pretty more accurate, but less melee damage and more melee damage as well, but the damage is lower. Harper's Ferries is lower, and so is the Springfield M1855. So we lose a lot of damage by switching to those. Maybe that's not the best idea to go with. The Palmetto stays within range and actually has better accuracy. Otherwise stays pretty strong overall. That might actually be the solution. Now the farmer is the same but less range, more fire rate and less accuracy but more melee. Ideally we want to end up with the Spencer, I believe. No, not really. I have no idea. Colt model 1855. It's a pretty good rifle. And the Springfield 1863, perhaps? Well, we'll look at it. I have no idea what to buy, actually. But I would say that the Palmetto actually looks really, really fucking good. And for reputation, then let's buy some Palmettos. And then give Walton the Palmettos to actually do something with. There we go, better equipped and we got spares. We're heading into the first Bull Run, and it's be really, really, really important to win, which I believe we can. I've done this before and I've won it. I've done it twice, or actually three times, and I've won it all three times. The only problem that's been with this campaign is that it's really, really deep, or really, really hard to do without suffering a fuck ton of damage and casualties. And it has pretty much depleted all my reserves every time, even though I gained 10. Even though I gained 16,000 men and, what is it, 278,300 for it. Even if with that, it's still horrible. So I have a hard time recovering from. Hopefully my new strategy will work. But let's get into it. It'll be a long episode this time. It won't be 30 minutes. It'll be more like an hour. All right. The Confederate Army of PGT Beauregard has deployed along Bull Run River to guard Manassas Railroad Junction. From the other side of the river, Brigadier General Irving McDowell, what an idiot, is seeking for a weak point to attack. Your forces will join McDowell and help him initiate an attack on the left at the left flank of the Confederate Army. So let's deploy and get that done with. This is going to be really... I can deploy 8 brigades. I am slightly above in details. Let's have a look. I'm bringing in my first corps with Keyes, Hunt, Ayer, Sherman. That's not my corps. That's the... That's my AI corps, which is really good, actually. I got the 3rd corps here and supplies. And I got the 2nd corps, which is me. Woo! I'm the 2nd corps this time. And I got my units being brought up. And as you can see, Walton has gotten some of his new rifles. And we're going to continue using them on that corps. We'll be joining the left flank in the attack. And the plan is to push across here, secure this bridge, and secure this as a fighting area. One division here, another one here, and one down here to guard this area with the artillery covering it. Then move the rest of our brigades in from behind and smash through. Securing this ridge first before the assault across here, where we then secure this area. That's at least the idea. It probably won't work. So, several miles east, the Confederate Army of PGT Beauregard is deployed. We already read that. The Confederate Army stretched out to defend all possible river passages. The left flank is vulnerable, and this is where the bulk of the Union Army is going to attack. At first, you're going to lead some of McDowell's troops in a decoy action at the stone bridge with the intention to hide the primary flanking maneuver through Sutley Ford, which is up here. So we'll be attacking across here, securing this. If we can hold this for long enough, the enemy will have to constantly focus on this while our troops can move in and secure the left flank. Next, your army and the main force of McDowell will execute a powerful attack from the west. The main objective is to surprise and quickly overwhelm Beauregard's left flank before Joseph E. Johnston's Army of the Shenandoah reinforce him. So the Army of the Shenandoah, if you're a history buff, you know this army. You also know that you'll end up fighting against the Stonewall Brigades, the 4th and 3rd Virginia, plus the 27th of Virginia, which would be awesome. So yeah, we'll be fighting against Stonewall Jackson in this campaign, one of my personal all-time heroes of the American Civil War. So let's get into this. The rebels are guarding the Manassas Railroad Junction with strong forces a few miles eastwards from this location. Okay. Bull Run River is defended by several CSA brigades and it's risky to pass. It is vital to initiate a feigned attack on the bridge with a small amount of regiments. That's what we'll be doing. Planning. Here we go. Our main force can press the river from this section and attack the left flank of the Confederate Army. We intend to do that, securing this position, then ultimately securing this hill. In fact, fast, the rebels will have no time to reinforce the area, and we can easily sweep them off the field. We intend to do that. This is where the battle will really take place, and we had bogged down last time. Then we'll move eastwards and deal the final blow. We can end the war today, General. Good luck. I intend to. All right. General, we're ready to execute the feigned attack at the Stone Bridge. At the Stone Bridge, yes. Some rebel regiments are guarding the area, so we need to be cautious. Okay, I thought we just did this. Okay. In about an hour, our divisions will be ready to launch a full-scale attack on the flank. We intend to do that and take this hill over here. Until then, keep the rebels busy. Good luck, General. Okay. So we got the 1st Ohio and the 2nd New York. Moving up. All right, let's put the... wrong way. Put them there. We got the 2nd U.S. Engineers, we'll put them here. That should give them plenty of line of fire. The 1st US Guard, we'll put them here, flanks, where we can cover with fire. All of these, let's have a look, yes. Put them up here. We'll rush across the river with all 3 regiments once we've set up artillery to fire. They're all pretty well equipped, so let's get some skirmishers out quickly. The skirmishers will take up the first line and actually deal with the initial attack. So we'll skirmish with some scouts. We'll skirmish with our skirmishers, of course. Dumb thing to say. But we'll move the skirmishers up to give the artillery a line of fire on the enemy and to support our now slightly weakened brigades. But the skirmishers will be able to defend some of the positions and give some flanking fire, which will be really good once we encroach on this town with the main brigades. Also, they'll draw the fire from any enemy artillery, which we should be seeing any moment now. There we go. Lichbuck. There, the first. The first LA Tigers. Fire. Fire. And then we'll bring these guys up to fire as well. Engaging in a little skirmish mode here. Yeah, we're losing some men. But we are inflicting casualties as well. That's good. We'll skirmish a little bit, forcing them to use their ammunition. As you can see, these are really inaccurate. Not really doing all too well. What are they firing with? I don't know. Maybe you should try and fire on that instead. Losing some casualties, suffering some casualties all around. They've lost one, killed three. Lost three, killed two. Oh, they've lost a lot of men. The second New York skirmisher division. We have to wait for the next fire from these to move our units further up the line. Then the Ohio divisions are going to launch an attack across the river to take Lynchburg out. As you can see, the casualties being suffered here are not massive. However, the casualties on our side are actually mounting. We'll wait for Lynchburg to fire next, and then we'll rush it with the Ohio's. There we go, he's shot, and we'll charge across, run. And the second New York will then go for that and run. So these two, once they reach the bridge, we will start the immediate charge. The Tigers are reloading. Fire coming in, still firing at the right targets. Please don't bunch up too much. This is a mistake. They're going to hit us with canister shots. There we go. The second New York is suffering. Charge across. Charge. Start the charge. Into the melee. Into the fray. Push the LA Tigers back. Support them with the skirmisher fire. Yes, Tompkins is wounded. There's nothing we can do about that. Get the first and second Ohio in on the charge. The New York is breaking because, well, they lost their commanding officer. But there we go. Rout on us, but the LA Tigers are going to take casualties now. Unfortunately, it's a little too late for the second New York, I think. First Ohio, come on with the charge. Get in there. Break the LA Tigers. If you're going to break them, there we go. Now it's through to Lynchburg. Through to Lynchburg. Straight onto Lynchburg. All units attack Lynchburg. Want him brought down. Our cavalry can cross the river undetected. Yes, it can. Across here. So let's lead the flanking attack. There we go. Our units have arrived. We'll bring them up here. Second Ohio, start the attack with the first Ohio taking that position. Skirmishers deploying on the left and the right flank. The first New York has recovered. Rebel cavalry spotted over there. Okay, that's not a good idea. Then they are guarding that position. Second Ohio move to support that. Lynchburg is retreating. And we are forcing them back. Bring the skirmishers over in this position. Fire. Bring these guys over to support. Support that cavalry attack. Our scouts aren't going to hold up against those dragoons, unfortunately. But we're going to have to try and do something here. To weaken that flank. Oh, they're routing. We managed to do it. We actually managed to do it. Sweet. Cook is wounded. That's not good.
Push them both that position. The divisions are still pushing up, that's good. We'll get more troops coming up that side as well. And we've secured the left hand of the river. Now, normally I would push across here immediately, but I know what's across there and I know it ain't good for us. So move these guys in to provide. General Beauregard is overseeing that. And that's Matthew Hill, if I'm not correct. More! Oh, Loomis and Cook are arriving in with MacArthur. Good, bring those guys over here. Forcing the LA Tigers off that path has really helped. Woods is coming as well. Bring all the troops into position. Really important. Got those coming in. Victory over here is not certain yet, but we are have been able to hold the Clay Dragoons, and we are forcing the 4th New York back. As you can see, we are going to have to fight Hampton's Legion. So bring these troops into position up here. The 2nd Ohio is going to support that, and these guys are supporting there. If we can hold this position just a little while longer, we will be able to actually inflict some heavy damage on Hampton's legions. So are we still receiving reinforcements from over here now? Let's just queue all of this up here. There we go. Okay. While we continue to place, Dragoon has attacked the 2nd Ohio skirmishers. 2nd Ohio is ready to support them, but they are suffering and have broken. Place Dragoons did really well there. While we are establishing our defenses here, Beauregard is going to get a shot right to his face. He's pulling back to support the left flank. A smart move. Let's move our skirmishers across here while we hold this area. There we go, the LA Tigers are reforming for another attack. We've got skirmishers up front who can actually see the positions of the supplies. This also means Beauregard is going to be taking... Oh, there we go, they're moving to across here, I believe. Or they're going to make a push for that position here, which we don't really want, so move these guys over here. Franklin and Wilcox has arrived. We want them over here to set up a flanking position there so we can secure this area. We know if they're going to push across because we've got the scouts. So we're going to move these guys back into defensive position. I want you to fire at Hampton's Legion. I'm sure Hampton's Legion suffers from wanting to move across there. Make sure Clay's Dragoons do not get a proper charge off here. There we go, we wiped them out. Reform the line in this direction, please. And you reform the line in this direction. Still receiving troops over here. That's really good. Really good. Let's, as you can see, B has now set up defensive position there. B's brigade is guarding. It's Howard is here to support. And Matthew is that, did you say Matthew? Bartho's brigade spotted. He's moved to defend Matthew Hill. Okay, so Pelham has set up defenses as well. If they move across, they are there moving across to get at our scouts, I think, or to defend that position. They're preparing to attack us, and we really don't want to fight a two-pronged attack. So we need to start the attack on the second hill. Scales, I want you to actually start firing at B. This is going to be a long haul for us. As you can see, Bartho is now attacking. Something that is going to be horribly bad for us. But we've got three lines of troops actually able to hold here. So Hampton's brigade is suffering from being shot at. But we'll have to stop the advance now. Unfortunate. Lee, Loomis, and MacArthur and Coke. Let's bring these guys up to actually start the attack. Coke, why aren't you going going in on this. I want you to support this attack, and I want you to run. I'll bring in Coop and Wilcox over here. Front. Need to start the attack on the other flank, because this flank is going to fold shortly. Move the first Ohio skirmishers over there to defend. Start the assault on B's position. Take care, run. I really want you to run. Franklin's moving in to support you. More troops have arrived. Sherman has arrived to support the attack on that flank. Good. Yeah. Sherman, please. If we can hold this long enough. Sherman's ready to cross the river. It should be lightly defended by now. No, it's not. It's actually really well defended. Loomis, you're taking way too much damage. Go for a charge. With Cook and MacArthur. I want this division cleared. Coop has now has possibly gotten to the position I wanted him to get, where he has now completely cut off the enemy retreat. Charge here. You move down here. Franklin is coming in to support the attack across this river crossing. And Bartho is broken. The lead, Hampton's Legion is holding, which is really good for them. Unit secured Matthew Hill. B is now being forced back. B is being overwhelmed. Hopefully. Will we immediately. Rebels withdraw to Henry Hill. Good. This is where they'll set up their defense. Yes, I remember that. And they'll be bringing troops with General Jackson. Yes, here he comes. Time to show Jackson what we are made of. We've pushed our lines forward. We must break the defences of this hill before the rebel reinforcements arrive. Waiting your orders to attack, yes. Having pushed forward enough, we now will attack Beauregard. Everything we have. Because I want him to die. Keyes is over here with extra troops. Sherman, why aren't you running? I want you to run with Keyes, please. He'll be arriving. There we go. Has been taken up. Move down to secure this. Cook, move down to secure this. Make sure that he does not reform. Bring our artillery up here. I want scales up here with Woods and Ricketts. Right here. So thank you very much. Beauregard is retreating. We've cut him off. Get across the river. Run. Ares and Hunt over here. And Keyes moving towards this position. The run. Run, please. Second Ohio, we've cut off the access to the river. Hampton's Legion is going to try and push across. So they're caught between the rock and a hard place over there, and they know it. Bartho is trying to flank. It's not going to work for him. Secure this position so that the Hampton's Legion cannot get across. Now Arthur moved down to support that attack. Al Wilcox secures that flank, and we attack Pelham in the rear. Which forces Pelham to retreat, which gives Sherman the option to move across the river and start the flanking maneuver. Pelham across the river. Franklin is moving to support that. Loomis move up to support this. Need to keep our troops moving forward constantly. Still remember, we have B over here somewhere. It's not going to be a pleasant fight for him. Here we go, our troops are arriving. These scouts will have to deal with Pelham. Our Wilcox is forming up to deal with Bartho. And Arias is setting up here. There we go. Go for Beauregard and go for that. We need to break through here so we can get ammunition into these guys. Liddell forward with supplies as well. Avarian forward to secure this. Enemy will be establishing defenses here, which will be really hard to break, but because we secured all the crossings, they will have to fight a losing battle to actually get across. And we think we killed Beauregard. Need to secure those. Not let them get across. I want, yes, I know we're getting fired at, but I want them. Want those supplies. I want those supplies. Oh, I want them taken out. Damn it. Alright, well, that's not bad. They turn on shot on our scouts. Just get the fuck out of there. That should be enough. Let's move Cook down here. Bees retreated. Good. Forward with these guys. Let's continue the attack. Well, this is actually my second division. Okay. Ah, not good. That'll be fine. These guys are guarding for Bartho, so let's just keep Bartho. As it stands right now, the LA Tigers have been forced to contest with way too many men, and even without the ammo, we got them. Stuart is being driven off. If we can resecure this hill, secure that hill, we'll have a strong artillery position. And Ricketts has arrived to support. The same with Scales, he'll be arriving to shoot. We'll have the artillery advantage and we can flank around. Bartho is still holding, which is really starting to annoy me. We need to break him. Sherman has turned this flank completely, which means these guys are completely fucked. But Sherman and Keyes, you need to reinforce these guys because we have opened up this theater and deploy these artillery units along here. Actually, along here. There we go. I need Letty over there with supplies. Want these two push forward. So push across here. Secure that. The 2nd Virginia and the 21st or 27th VA has arrived. Our forces here are spread pretty thin. Oh, Stuart just got surprised by Keyes and Sherman's arrival. Ricketts. You will have to move down here to actually fire, won't you? Yeah. Scales, I don't want you to attack those guys, actually. All troops prepare to attack. Fire across. First Ohio, you don't have the... none of you have the supplies yet. So we'll have to... second Ohio across. You've done really well for yourself, guys. Sherman, push across. Keys do the same. Skirmishers down here. We're doing over here. Has Barthel completely surrendered? I believe Franklin can deal with that. Wilcox, please support the attack down here. Jackson is doing, they're doing really well with holding this position, I have to say. Unfortunately, what they're doing is just too little, too late. Already now we're pushing back across these lines here. We might be weakened. We've got reinforcements coming in the form of Wilcox as well, while Franklin continues to hold out. Actually, let's get our scouts back there. They're not really doing anything up here. Let's just check what's going on over there. There's an excellent artillery position we have up here. And B is really feeling our position while Howard pushes up to force Jackson to back off. I think we have a flank over here. And the 5th Virginia has moved to defend us, or moved to actually deal with us. Barthel has sneaked around us. I knew it, sneaky bastard. That means Wilcox will have to move back to secure that entry. He's trying to get a sneaky flank off that bastard. Secure that flank. You should be able to move up to Broken Bow, bro here. But we are forcing the 2nd Virginia to actually fight us. In what appears to be, oh, B has just given us a flank. Fired B before he managed to correct it, and that actually brought B to a wrap, which means we can move up with this division, move across to that. That B made a grave mistake there. We can now attack the artillery because we've got troops on the flank. Means a charge in here would not actually be a bad idea. These guys are rotating. You can fire. Oh, Keith was killed, damn it. His orders are get fire on B. You turn to fire at B and then start the charge there. Charge, goddammit. They're broken across the river. Yeah, Barthel is gonna fall straight into a trap here. This is a costly battle, but there we go. We've broken this line. Advance up across the river. An enemy will not be able to withstand a combined charge from that. You charge in, Keys. Charge. First call. We've suffered a few casualties, I'll admit to that, but same time we've managed to pretty much break this position. So, holy shit, reinforcements are arriving. B's back, so Stuart. The 2nd Ohio, I'll have to redeploy you over here. Jackson is coming in to inspire his men. There we go. Howard suffered hugely by doing what he just did, but We managed to actually establish ourselves. Why are you turning around?
Confederate counterattack. Oh no, General, men are exhausted from the continuous fight and more rebels are coming. Defend our machine and not advance further.
We'll deal with that. They managed to push us off, back off that, but we'll continue our advance. We've not lost yet. Over here, we completely wiped out Bartho, who will now retreat, and flesh forces can be brought in. Good. Ricketts is doing well. Sherman has had to fight B, and Keyes returned to the fight. Second Ohio is moving to secure this position, while the Second New York is offering all kinds of support. Again, Cook, Loomis, over on this side, Howard, reform. Whatever the enemy is throwing at us, we will throw back at them 10 times harder. Do we understand each other, gentlemen? General Johnston has been spotted with many infantry brigades. He must have used the railroad to travel here so fast. Oh no! We shall not give our position away, gentlemen. Our supply by little has been emptied. Oh well. Couldn't be helped, I guess. Bartho is retreating, good. Fight continues down the middle. We might need to bring up more supplies now. Force them back. Loomis, reestablish this. Keyes is retreating. But our troops are arriving. Reinforcements are coming over. Cobb is coming over as well. Howard has reformed and is pressing the advantage. Keyes is back. Keyes is back. Take position in the forest. I don't really want you to fight. Sherman is being charged in the flank by Cook. Actually, just keep firing. Support them here. Support them here. Loomis, I need you over there quickly, but not too quickly. MacArthur, you're relaxing. Why are you relaxing? Bring up your forces. First Ohio, forward. I want them pushed off this hill. There we go. What's this? Back up firing. They're pushing us off the left flank, but we're pushing them back off the right. Oh. Another charge coming in for Bunham. This is not good. We have Loomis. I need you to run now because we need you to form that line. Keys and charge into those keys. The Second Ohio has finally given in, it seems. Barnum has reformed the center. First Ohio is still in the fight, which is really good. Keyes is being forced back. But Sherman has reformed, Loomis has arrived to support the attack, and the Second New York has broken. We'll keep this forward going because Stuart is there, dammit. They've broken the rest, but Stuart needs. Bring the Second New Yorks. Yeah, we're running out of ammo on these. There's nothing we can do now. Wrap on Keyes, goddammit. Union secured Henry Hill, good. Continue to move the supplies forward. They'll continue to push for that. Stop them. There's a lot more infantry brigades here than I remember. Holy shit, Smith has arrived. Reform the line. Reform the line! You're not a charge. I didn't order you to charge. Order you to attack. Fire! Halt! Jesus Christ, people, fire! They turn that flank, we're screwed. Wilcox, move over there. Franklin, forward. We've reformed on the right flank. We've reformed on this flank. Keep Bonham fighting. Keyes, you're wounded. Okay, I move up with these guys. I'm gonna charge. We will not have it. That line is 2nd Virginia has broken. And just keep Sherman there for now. If you can just break Bonham, that would be really great. The fight is now on the right, on the left flank. Wilcox, you need to fucking run. And your skirmishes as well. Wilcox, why aren't you running? Run, damn you, run! Loomis is broken. First Ohio is fighting, but it's running out of supplies. Need to hold for 2 hours or break them. Either will work for me, guys. Boys, either will work. That's a rat on Sherman. Bring Keys in to support. Oh, B is suffering from Wilcox. Wilcox have arrived. Loomis has reformed. Bring him forward. Holy shit, that's a lot of troops here. Counterattack is indeed effective. But our troops are equally effective at holding. How's our supplies? Cook, you have just held that position for so long. Force them back. General is still over there. I don't really know where you are, but get over here. There we go. You're flanked. I don't know why you're flanked. You are Sherman, back across. We gained some morale. Our regiment is actually holding. Our corps is holding. That's good. It's good. This is a hard battle. We managed to push the enemy back. That's good. They'll reform and they'll try again. Loomis is recovering his condition. So is MacArthur. Keyes is in no condition to fight right now. Now there's Sherman. So reform and defend. That's all you have to do, Keyes. Same for Sherman. You two will hold that line. If you're tired and you're weakened. Oh, Smith is trying for a push on a whole weakened Howard. Loomis will move up to support him with Cook. Franklin into the trees, please. MacArthur supporting Walton moving up here and Cook forward to fill out the gap here. Smith and Holmes are really trying for that flank. We cannot let them have that. Yes, ammo's low. We need to bring our supplies over there. Cook is trying to come up. Bonham and skirmishers are threatening their flank with Loomis coming in to support Franklin. This is a bloody battle. Ewell is coming up, it means Walton will have to support Cook, and Wilcox will have to support that. Charge that down the middle, it's a good tactic. Good tactic, boys. But Smith has been met by 3 brigades. You cannot turn, you have to hold Ewell. Wilcox will have to support Franklin and MacArthur in the middle. Actually, no. Well, Crux is dealing, Walton is dealing with that. Loomis will support Keyes and Sherman, who are dealing with Bonham again. They've recovered enough condition to move. Push them off that line, push them off that line. Good. Try and recover. We know they will. Hard, you need to reform your line. The second New York across the river. So you should push up. If the enemy is retreating, we keep them retreating. Jepson is fortifying over there with him. Let's fortify with our general over there. The Hampshire Legion, or Hampton's Legion, is still there. Actually thought they would have been broken by now, but okay. They've been fighting from the start. That's pretty good. Sherman, what are you doing? You're not supposed to charge, you're just supposed to shoot. Funnily enough, Keyes' Legion is the only one fit enough to do a charge. And the enemy is routing. So this flank has completely been turned. Again, means MacArthur and Loomis can do what they do best. Oh, Cook is returning. Bonham is now completely being wiped out. Just what we like, would like to see. Loomis, support this attack, please. Keyes can hold that. Broke. God damn it. But he didn't manage to get his line reformed in time. So we countercharged. Give Smith all the support he needs. Okay, Wilcox, all the support he needs so that Smith doesn't break those lines. Walton, you need to hold these guys in place. Franklin, move up. Cook and Hampton's Legion are actually fighting really well right now. Second New York has done their part as well. First Ohio is still with us. Yes, the First Ohio is still with us. Sweet. Wilcox skirmishes are still here. Smith broke. That means we can focus on it. Getting Holmes out of the way. It's a long, grueling battle. So it looks like now Smith is actually being forced back again, which was pretty much what we wanted. Newell has been forced to give up that, which is pretty good. We can now take it. Wow, Confederate and Union dead are littering this field. This is a horrible display of cruelty and savagery. A little bit exciting as well. Shove all our supplies on this battle. And we've driven the enemy back. They are now going to be fighting on uneven ground, unfavorable ground, so even if they reform, they will not be able to push us out. I think they will reform though, I'm pretty sure of it. Look at them, they're only wavering. Yeah, Holmes has already reformed, Ewell has been reformed, and Cook. So Cook can take that position. If he can that'll be pretty good for them. But the rest of the troops are forcing back to this hill, I believe. And the AI is brutal in this game. Yeah, Cook is charging, don't charge. Yes, that's what will happen. Force them back off these positions. Cook, no! Already fucking told you. Do not charge, hold. Loomis is doing really well for his casualty rate. God damn it, Cook, you look pushed up way too far. But Coke is gonna fall. Look at that. Worth it, no. Switch around. I want you that facing that way. Thank you. Which will bring Cook down. Or Cook down. Cook across the channel. How are you going to do that? Cook. You'll deal there. 16 minutes in the. Game time to go, and we'll have done this. An awesome battle. We're not supposed to be meleeing. God damn it, guys. Oh well. Push them off. Don't imagine anything can cause this battle to be lost right now, but I guess I live to be proven wrong. Oh, these are casualties we do not need, guys. Why are you charging? The order was not to charge, the order was to fucking shoot them in the face with bayonets. Oh, with your rifles, right? Hampton's legion broke. Earl is now engaged in the lead with Loomis and Loomis. And Sherman is coming in to support. Ewell falls, we can. That's the largest unit yet, so. Smith is what Cobb needs to focus on. Or how it deals with Hampton's legions. And Sherman deals with Holmes. And Ewell is now in full retreat. Franklin, help with Holmes. I think the battle will be over by the time the rest of the troops arrive. Before we can get to do anything more, yeah, 2 minutes. Here we go, end the battle. You can finish the mission. There we go. Lost 18,000. I had 18,000. I lost 5,000. Ah, twice the casualties I had. Yes. That's how we do it. That is how we do it. Did you see that? That is how we do it. All right. How long has this been running for now? An hour. All right. Well, I guess we'll accept this. And we'll leave it at that and save the game. Thank you all so much for watching. And if you liked the video, please leave a like at the bottom of the YouTube channel. And remember to subscribe to the channel if you want to see more of my content. Thank you all so much for watching, and see you next time.